Hey, hello everyone. My name is Raquel Madeira. I'm your health solutions coach, and thank you so much for being here for this live. The subject today is why we gave up already on our New Year's resolutions. So, you know already if you are there with me, if you are live with me, you can always contact with me straight away, message me, and I will reply straight away. Or you can message me later on. You can email me, whatever do you want. So, let's talk a little bit about New Year's resolutions. According to a USA report, 80% of people who promised or who wanted to make changes in their lives by now gave up. So 80% of us already are not doing what we promised just 4 weeks ago. So why is this happening? So I'm basing this, so in my research, I'm basing in four problems. So why we already gave up on our goals, and we're gonna start for that. And I'm gonna read this to you. Maybe your goal is not clear. When you set your goal, maybe you didn't really search for the meaning behind your goal. This is an exercise I always do with my clients. Imagine you want to lose weight. Why do you really want to lose weight? How does it make you feel in your life? How does your life change after you get your goal? If it's easy for you to reply those questions, that's great. You are on the right track. But if you really need time to think about, maybe you need to stop and to take a moment to think deeply into your goals. Okay? Hello. Hello, Jose. Hola. So this is the first thing you need to check on is your goals. How clear are your goals? And losing weight is not a clear goal. You need to define your goal like I want to be 10 kilos lighter. And I always put my clients really, hello Bruno, really with the amount of weight they want to have. So I don't really look for I want to lose 10 kilos, but instead I want to be 50 kilos, for example. So check your goal like that and be specific about the goal you want to have and what is the meaning behind that goal. Losing weight is not what you want to achieve, is the feeling behind. And if you already before had the amount of weight you want to lose, remember how did you feel before? If you didn't, imagine how would you feel when you will lose the weight you want to lose? If is that your goal, I'm just giving you an example. Is the confidence you are looking for? Is not just fitting on that amazing clothes. Is more than that. Is deeper than that. So you need to look for that depth into your goal. Okay, so this is the first one. Is your goal clear? And check on that. The second one is you feel overwhelmed. So usually when we set our new resolutions, when we check on our New Year's resolution, sorry, we are excited, we are just thinking about to having the change, to making the change, but maybe you don't look what is the path we need to have that change. So what is our new life to get to our goals? We need to do some changes for sure to get to a new goal. We know that. Yes, Bruno, we know that. So all that changes, are we ready to take that changes? Usually we want to set a goal, but maybe you are not ready, or we don't really know what we need to do to be there and the changes we need to embrace if we are ready for that. Sometimes we feel a lot of pressure from our relatives, from our partners, from society, even from us. Sometimes we put too much pressure on us to get to that goal. And then we fail, and then we give up, because we are just thinking about to get there, and we are not taking the time we need to get there. So check on that, the pressure you have around you and the pressure you put into yourself. Check on that on your goal. The third point I'm gonna share with you is regarding you feel discouraged. And this is really, really use is really I'm missing the word. It's very common to watch this on the journeys of losing fat and getting shape, because people is putting effort now. They are losing energy now. It's tiring. We have pain associated, and we don't feel results straight away. We need time to get change. And remember, when was your last time when you exercise, or when was your last time when you were eating right? This is speaking about on fitness journey. You need time again. If you didn't exercise for 5 years, 2 years, 10 years, you cannot expect for 1 week, 2 weeks, 3 weeks doing your best and seeing results straight away. It's impossible. You need to give time. You need to be patient. And more important than that, you need to be persistent on that. So just go on small goals. Sometimes we see that's so long, seems so long the way. It looks like your road is so, so far away. And you feel like, I cannot do that, because you feel like it's so long. So my advice for you is, of course, you need to have in your mind the big goal. I don't know how many kilos you want to lose, how shape you want to get, how tone you want to get. It doesn't matter what is your goal. If you feel like it's so, so far, set small goals. Even your goal is there, every week you need a goal to be accomplished. And your goal can be, I need to go to the gym 3 times. I need to exercise. I need to move my body. I need to sweat for 30, 40, 45 minutes for 3, 4 times a week. This is a small baby, a baby goal. Is easier to accomplish, and you feel so proud of you when you accomplish. So set small goals for you to motivate yourself and to get yourself on the right track. And then step by step, move one leg after another, and you will see your road is not that long anymore. It seems closer when you start to see results. It takes some time, but as soon as you see the results, keep moving forward. I know you always want to have more and more results, but progress, I always share this, progress is always progress. So even if you just lost 1 kilo, if you just lost 1 inch, if you just lost 1 centimeter on your waist, it doesn't matter, it's still progress. So embrace your progress, be proud of yourself, and keep moving forward, because that road will be smaller and you'll be closer to your goal when you don't even imagine you are there. Okay? And the fourth point I'm gonna focus on is, maybe you are not ready for change yet. And this made all sense to me, because you know, I have been on diets on off for more than 10 years. I have also a eating disorder, and I don't do New Year's resolutions anymore. I really set goals and I stick to my plan. And even if it's not a straight line, and I'm not saying that's very easy, it's just a line from the start to the finish and you just need to go. That's not like that. You have a lot of up and downs. But the main thing is, you never give up. You fall, you stand up again, and you try again. And for more than 10 years, I had New Year's resolutions, because you think it's a new year, you want to change, you want to start something new, and a few weeks after, you already gave up, because maybe that goal is not your priority. So what this point says, maybe you are not ready for that goal yet. It doesn't mean that goal is not very important for your dreams, for yourself, but maybe at this point you have some other priorities. So imagine your fitness journey is very important to you, but at this point you are struggling in your work, you are struggling with money, you are struggling with some issues in your family. Maybe those goals are more important for you right now than your fitness journey, even if your fitness journey is very important to you. So my advice for you is, if you have something very important to you right now, at this point, get it sorted, work for it, and then when that problem, when that goal is sorted, then go for your fitness journey. Alright, I'm not saying you need to give up on that, I'm not saying you need to stop doing something for it, but I know maybe you're not 100% focused. So focus 100% what you need to be right now, what you need to focus right now, and then focus 100% on your fitness journey. And from there, just make a plan. Just be persistent, consistent, and you will get there. And if you never, never, never give up, I assure you, you will get to the goal you want to achieve. Okay, so this is the why we are not following our New Year resolutions, why we already gave up. I don't feel like that. I feel like I don't do, as I said, New Year's resolutions. I make goals to myself all year long, but I have goals to achieve and I set them every year. So by now I have some things as I feel like up and down. They could be, I could be closer to them, and I'm not there because of me. I didn't do the work, or I didn't do enough to get the point I could be, but that's okay. You cannot move to the past, you cannot change anything from there, but you can change your present and your future from now on. So my advice for you is, check all the tips, and I will just remind all of them. So the 4 points we focus on today, why we already gave up on our New Year's resolution, is your goals are not clear. So work deep into your goals and find your why. The second point is, you feel overwhelmed. Maybe you set your goals and you didn't really check what was the road to take, what was the path, what was the work you had to do. So check again on that. And if you don't have a plan, and if you don't really know what to do to get there, ask a professional and they will help you for sure. The third point is, you feel discouraged. So you don't feel strength around you, you don't feel the people around you is giving you support. Maybe you are putting too much pressure on yourself. So check small goals, baby goals on the way to get to the big one. So if you have a bigger goal to achieve, and you should have that big goal, set small goals, baby goals to achieve every week, every month, whatever it works for you. Okay, and the fourth point we check today, we are not ready for the change. So if you're not ready for this change, check again on you. What are the priorities for you right now? What are your goals, and which one of them are more important than your fitness journey right now? So if you check on those 4 points, which one makes more sense for you right now? Why you are not getting the results you want to get? What are the goals you are not going to them, and why this is happening? So check on those 4 points, make your homework, take some time to check on you, because in the meantime, you are the only responsible, you are the only one who can make the change. We always can get support, we always can get someone to push us, but it's all up to us to make the change and to last it forever. Okay, so this is what I want to share with you. Thank you so much for being there. I'm gonna save this and I'm gonna share on YouTube if you want to watch the full live. So, or you can also watch this as soon as I post this, because it's gonna be available for 24 hours. So please give me your questions, get in contact with me. Thank you again so much for being on that side. I will be on Facebook at 8 p.m. speaking in Portuguese and sharing the same information with you, but in Portuguese. Also, if you want to share anything about your fitness journey, any question you may have regarding nutrition, motivation, fitness, programs, anything, please do it. I have also something to share with you. I'm just a few days to release my website, raquelmadeira.com, so it will be available very, very soon. I'm just finishing a few things and I hope in the end of this week I'm gonna share what have been very challenging to me, everything made by myself, with no IT help, so it was a big challenge to me, and I'm gonna share a lot of things to you very soon, so wait for it. My name is Raquel Madeira, I'm your health solutions coach. I'll see you very soon. Bye.